Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy.
In this lecture, we will discuss about the interrelationship between cytokine storm and aging. Strangely, flinty evidences have been shown that the severity of COVID-19 infection varies widely from children, usually asymptomatic, adults with mild infection, as well as elderly adults appears to be more severe, typically deadly critical. It has proven that COVID-19 infection in some elderly critical adults leads to a cytokine storm, which is characterized by severe systemic elevation of several pro-inflammatory cytokines. Then, a cytokine storm can induce arrhythmias, ARDS, pneumonia, as well as multiple organ failure in aged patients. It is far from clear till now that why cytokine storm induced in only COVID-19 elderly patients and not in young patients. Answer to this question is, it seems that cytokine storm phenomena is associated with age, because aging is related to increased levels of systemic pro-inflammatory cytokines and decreased levels of anti-inflammatory cytokines. Ample studies have indicated elevated levels of interleukin 6, interleukin 1, tumor necrosis factor alpha, as well as C-reactive protein in aged subjects. Among other cytokines, these cytokines are reported to be high in patients with severe cases of COVID-19. In which interleukin 6 plays a key role in contribution to cytokine storm. Accordingly, it seems that increased generation of pro-inflammatory markers due to SARS-CoV-2 and aging have a critical role in the process of cytokine storm in severe COVID-19 patients. Although the exact underlying mechanism of cytokine storm in elderly adults with severe COVID-19 infection is far from clear, however, it seems that cytokine storm phenomena in elderly patients with severe COVID-19 infection is associated with many age-related pathophysiologic processes, including alteration of angiotensin-converting enzyme 2 receptor expression, excess reactive oxygen species production, alteration of autophagy, senescent adipocytes activity, mean the inflammatory phenotype of senescent cell activity, particularly adipose tissues, and immune senescence, as well as lack of vitamin D content. Here, we are going to review and discuss all above mentioned age-related pathophysiological pathways that appear to contribute to the dysregulation of cytokine networks and possibly a cytokine storm in elderly patients with severe COVID-19 infection. First of these, we will discuss relation between aging and angiotensin-converting enzyme 2 receptor. The renin angiotensin system is an important regulator of several physiologic events, including cardiovascular and blood volume, diabetes, in chronic renal disease. This system is composed of two different pathways which have opposing effects to stimuli, which are angiotensin converting enzyme angiotensin 2 and angiotensin receptor type 1 pathway. This pathway is related to tissue injury, inflammation, and fibrosis. The other pathway is angiotensin converting enzyme 2 angiotensin 7 mass receptor pathway that exerts anti-inflammatory and anti-fibrosis effects. Recently, it is well accepted that ACE2 on lung epithelial cells are the entry point receptors for COVID-19 particles and making it unattainable to catalyze the reactions. Unfortunately, several studies identified that ACE2 expression significantly reduces with aging. These evidences may partially suggest that the increased concentration of ACE2 receptors in lung epithelial cells in children and young adults may have a protective effect on severe clinical manifestations due to COVID-19 infection. Therefore, it is highly likely that low ACE2 expression with aging can lead to cytokine storm. After this, the next topic of our lecture is the relation between aging and excess production of reactive oxygen species. It is well accepted that reactive oxygen species, considered as a signaling molecule at low concentration and also as a mediator of inflammation at high concentration. The main sources of reactive oxygen species are mitochondrial respiratory chain in NADPH oxidase. It is suggested that RS production augment with age and the excess RS production in aging can initiate many pro-inflammatory cytokines generation through activation of multiple transcription factors, including nuclear factor kappa B, activator protein 1, specificity protein 1, and 4-oxysome proliferator activated receptors, and subsequently increased release of pro-inflammatory cytokines including TNF-alpha, interleukin-1-beta, interleukin-2, and interleukin-6, as well as adhesion molecules. Interestingly, as the excess RS production can increase pro-inflammatory cytokines, the pro-inflammatory cytokines can also increase RS production. Hence, excess RS production and inflammation are closely related, which are taking part in the pathogenesis of chronic inflammation and cytokine storm in elderly adults. After this, aging and autophagy. Autophagy is a conserved catabolic turnover pathway in eukaryotic cells by which cellular material delivered into the lysosomes for degradation. Autophagy process is related to the maintenance of cellular homeostasis, and its dysregulation could lead to the development of several aging-related pathophysiological diseases. It has been shown that the autophagy process decreases during aging and leads to the accumulation of damaged macromolecules and organelles. Importantly, mitochondria, which is the major source of RS, result in increased RS production. In this context, two major processes are for protection from harmful effects of RS, including mitophagy and antioxidant capacity. At one side, mitophagy, which is characterized by autophagic degradation of mitochondria, decreased with aging. On the other hand, decreased mitophagy together with decreased antioxidant capacity during aging can increase RS level in the body. The excess production of RS leads to increased pro-inflammatory cytokine secretion. Although the exact underlying mechanism of how the decline in autophagy and a rise in RS levels during aging can elevate pro-inflammatory cytokine release is far from clear. However, it is well accepted that low activity of autophagy process and high level of RS production during aging can activate and upregulate node-like receptors. It is observed that activation of cytosolic enolates increase during aging and can increase the production of pro-inflammatory cytokines, including interleukin-1-beta and interleukin-18. So, it seems that crosstalk between the decline of mitophagy pathways and elevated RS levels during aging can imbalance immune system activity of elderly adults. Aging in senescent adipocytes. Senescent cells accumulate with aging in many human tissues, leading to chronic inflammation and organ dysfunction. Senescent cells have lower cell viability, as well as insufficient protection against oxidative stress. Adipose tissue is a dynamic structure that plays an important contribution in modulating of metabolism and inflammation. It is highly likely that adipose tissue dysfunction in aged obese subjects leads to more serious complications of COVID-19 as compared to younger individuals. As in obese COVID-19 patients, the adipose tissue interacts with the immune system and increases the lethality of the infection by fair tissue associated cytokines or adipokines, which are released, like a myeloid A, which act directly on macrophages and increase generation of proinflammatory cytokines. Therefore, the elevated release of proinflammatory cytokines by senescent adipocytes possibly leads to the elevated risk of the cytokine storm in COVID-19 patients. And with this, thanks for watching, and the remaining part of this lecture will be covered in the next video. Make sure you have subscribed to our channel to don't miss it.